All right, so my name is Nick Leiser, the editor-in-chief of The Escapist, joined by Marty and Amy, and we are going to be discussing our thoughts on the new Rainbow Six game, Rainbow Six Extraction, which is a new Ubisoft original, gotta get it right now, cooperative shooter set in the Rainbow Six universe that takes sci-fi and co-op, and it's more Rainbow Six, I guess.
Well, you say it's more Rainbow Six, but it feels, to me, it feels very different from Rainbow Six Siege, which I'm not a huge Siege fan. I know you guys are, but this is definitely, it's a 1-to-3-player cooperative game, and it very much is in line with stuff like Left 4 Dead or GTFO or even the, what was the game that was announced yesterday? The Anachronism, which was like the 70s sci-fi game. And I thought the sort of the overall concept and the way it was, it didn't take itself super seriously with like the aliens who come down and then kind of become goopy zombies, but that married with the like tactical team mechanics of all the different operators in Rainbow Six Siege seemed like a good mix to me, honestly. Like, I'm much more intrigued to play this than core Siege personally.
Yeah, I was worried before we saw it that it was literally just going to be Left 4 Dead in Rainbow Six. Not that that would be terrible or anything, but because there was leaked alpha, pre-alpha gameplay not too long ago, and it didn't look that fun. That the way they showed it off there, it looks like they've expanded on the concept a bit. And the two things that really interested me with that was that it had rogue-lite elements, where if an operator goes down in the mission, they stay MIA. So to me, that's saying like, you know, you have your huge selection of operators, you lose them in the mission, and then you got to go back and go get them out. That's a really cool mechanic, in my opinion. It kind of sets it apart. My biggest issue with like the cooperative shooters like that is a lack of any risk reward. It's just kind of you go and you die or you don't finish a mission. With this, like, there's a reason to go back and not fuck up. And the way they have the structure where you start on tier one, you go to tier two, tier three, it gets progressively harder too. So it's not just setting a difficulty, it's going to scale while you're in the game. And that's interesting.
I think the thing as well with the dynamic of having different operators out at any point in time, if you don't do particularly well with one, I really like how that's going to encourage a bit more diversity and range in the play style, which will in turn help you get better at it in general by understanding the different mechanics of each operator and how they grow, because the fact that it takes away your progress and things from them too is a really interesting way to get better at the game. And I'm really, really excited by it. It just looks really cool. I like Siege. I like the way it feels to play, and getting a co-op of that is like, I'm just really excited. And I think it looks right up my alley.
Yeah. And the operators were already kind of like built for that with Siege and having all the different abilities. So that was one thing they didn't really show, is like the combining of different abilities. Like, you saw that they had, like, you know, there's the scanning techniques and all that, but, you know, each operator in Rainbow Six Siege has their own special, unique ability. So I'm curious, like, how, like, the destruction of levels is going to play into that. We saw a little clip of that where he shot through the wall, but I'm curious if, like, there's going to be environmental puzzles around that.
Yeah, and it seems like they're also bringing in, obviously, like, those sort of the you know, level altering mechanics of Siege, as well as they showed the thing like the BioLite, to where you're able to scan walls and scan enemies. And it seemed like the enemies were almost like those zombies near the end of Resident Evil 4, where you had to scan to realize the exact point in their body where you could do damage. So it looks like there's gonna be certain enemies where you have to do headshots, or certain ones where you have to hit them in the heart. And then the other thing, interesting thing, like we were talking about during the stream, of like, how is this game gonna be priced? Is this gonna be free to play, or like a budget price or full price? They did announce it is full price. So it's a full price game, and it is coming. Yeah, full price, $59.99, coming September 16th. And it's coming to the PC, the streaming consoles, and then both generations of Xbox and the PS4, PS5. And then along with Rainbow Siege proper, they're working on crossplay, which they said with consoles will be sometime in 2022. And they also said there's going to be some sort of form of communication between Siege and Extraction, at least in terms of like you can earn upgrades in one that impact the other one. So
yeah, and I'm assuming they do a new operator in Siege, it comes to Extraction at the same time.
Yeah, and it's a good way to, you cater to your hardcore fans who've been playing Siege for the last, you know, 5-6 years, as well as obviously drawing a new audience who, you know, the fact that the game can be played single player with two AI companions, I think it's cool. Like, I think that again, draws a different audience who just might not want to wade into the multiplayer waters.
Yeah, I think the two things I'm curious about is, well, first, let's go back to the price for a second. I don't think anybody should be really surprised by that, considering how many people play Siege. I mean, I'm sorry, that's just easy money for them to make. But as far as continuation of the game, like, yeah, I'm curious what their long-term strategy for it is with, like, new... I'm sure we're going to, you know, they're going to do the operations and the live service model with it. Why would they not with that setup?
If you go in for $60 at the start, like, at what point are you going to start having to pay more money to play it? You know, if this was free to play, or if this was a budget price, then I would understand having to buy battle passes or seasonal things.
That's pretty much a Siege model. Like, you don't pay money. You don't have to pay money for the extractions. You pay for the season pass once a year, and you get all the expansions.
But it took them a while to get to that model, if you remember. The Siege we have today is definitely not the Siege that launched day one. So Siege and For Honor are the two games that I think Ubisoft has done the best job of releasing, and then clearly listening to user and fan feedback and kind of writing the ships and creating something that have these incredibly long tails and really deep communities.
It's a cooperative shooter, but I'm curious how much the story is going to play into it, if there is. You know, it's just initial cutscenes, because they don't do anything with story really in Siege, but they have like all this interesting lore and stuff behind the back, the characters. But
I mean, they said there was like the aliens landed in places like Alaska and San Francisco, New York. So I mean, we'll get like varied maps, but I don't know if any of that's going to amount to like an actual compelling story.
Compelling, I guess, is obviously we'd have to wait and see. But like speculative, I feel like, considering they did mention, you know, this is an evolved form. Like after what we saw during the outbreak in New Mexico, like the fact that they mentioned that specifically in the stream does make me think that there is an idea here that will be elaborated upon as to how this parasite has grown and changed and how it wasn't contained in the first place, I suppose, and how it was allowed to get to this point. So I think that could be really interesting, because again, I was someone that really enjoyed the Outbreak event. So I'm definitely keen to see how they expand upon that idea. And it looks promising.
Also, in games like Left 4 Dead, to me, the story isn't the story they created. The story is the like personal experiences you and your buddies have, like barely making it through a level alive. And like that's the kind of story that I think is important in these kind of games. And, you know, if the gameplay is good and you have a couple pals to play it with, then I think that's you make your own stories.
Yeah, you know, I'm not expecting anything super groundbreaking from it, but I mean, like, Rainbow Six Siege's gunplay is great, the abilities are great, so if you're just getting a co-op experience in a unique, or not really even unique, but interesting setting, I'm down for that. Like I said, it had a lot more depth than I was expecting. That was my biggest concern with that game, was just going to be cash-in spinoff, but it looks more than that, and that has me at least interested. At least it'll be a good night for game night, or a good game for game nights. Well, there's only three players though. Why is three player co-op a thing? Why are we not sticking with four? Even numbers, guys. Why is this a thing?
Counterpoint, odd numbers, Triforce.
No. I refuse.
Maybe the research shows people only have two friends.
That's true. Thank you so much for watching our coverage of Rainbow Six Extraction. For Amy and Nick, I am Marty. For everything else, E3, Ubisoft, and everything in between, you're already in the right place, The Escapist.